Hello, good morning, friends. I welcome you all for this 29th session, System Software. I hope you enjoyed all the lectures. I hope you have downloaded the lectures, PPTs, and videos from FTP site. I don't know, but I wish that you should visit the FTP site. It is very important because you have to submit the practical. Maybe at the end, they will declare the date. So it may happen that you will be doing hurry. You will not get much time to do the practicals. So visit the site and get the list of practicals. Actually, there is a table, practical list table, which is an old table. I'm going to modify it. But what I suggest is that you should go through the list. Means you will understand what types of practicals are there generally in system software, what is expected in system software. So before beginning, I just wish, I request you to raise your hand for just 1 second so that I will understand everybody is able to. Thank you, Aishwarya, Chinmay, Gargi, Nayan, Rasika, Shivani, Pratiksha, Prasad, Sahil, Gauri, Sakshi, Sampada, Nisha. Okay. So today there are very few members. Tanuja is also there. Chinmay is there. Anyway, today very less number of people are there anyway. But I suggest tell them to join and also tell them that attendance is compulsory and it is a major criteria to compute your internal marks, not in this subject, in all subjects. So never miss any lecture. Only 2 lectures are there in a day. So you can join a lecture. I suggest you to join all the lectures. Anyway, I will go ahead. So today's agenda, it is the same agenda, last session's agenda, but today we are going to see in a little slow, fast. We are going to understand what is LR0 atom, sorry, LR1 atom. We have seen last time the definition in a last lecture. I think Swaraj mic is on. Swaraj, try to mute the mic, Swaraj. Thank you, Swaraj. So today we shall see the look at the go to and closer. Same concept is used. Please also note that when you understand how to design a SLR parser, same concept is used to design the CLR parser, means canonical LR parser, as well as LALR parser. So actually, we shall compare the power of these parsers, because syntax analysis is a major component of any compiler. So parsing, what the parsing method is used in particular compiler, it may be of C or Java, whatever compiler is there. So the method, syntax method or syntax analysis method or parsing method is very, very important. It is what we do is syntax analysis and it consumes 90% importance. So anyway, we are going to see. Last time I have told you what is shift reduce and reduce conflict. So we have seen large number of parsing tables. Parsing table can be any table. It may be LL1 parsing table or LL2 parsing table, SLR parsing table, or it may be CLR parsing table. You will find that in every column or in every cell in that table, there is only one entry, one production or one action is there. But if there are multiple action like shift and reduce, then we say that it is a conflict. But suppose there is a shift conflict, so normally shift conflict is we are not able to encounter it anywhere. But shift reduce conflict is there and reduce conflict is there. Means uh, you have to decide whether to do shift operation or whether to do reduce operation. So that is a complex thing. So that is avoided in CLR parser, canonical LR parser. That is the main advantage. But CLR has different advantages. Disadvantages, because CLR is a very complex to design. It is very large. It has a very large parsing table. Large number of states are there. So manually, it is very hard to design a CLR parser. And you will find that there is something called as a ALR, that is a look ahead LR parser. That is a convenient, that is a powerful. But in case of power, means power of covering all types of the programming constructs, programming language constructs like if then else, do while, repeat until, whatever complexities are there, loop, jumps, parameter passing mechanisms, everything, all types of complexities in programming constructs is captured by CLR parser. That is not case with SLR and LALR. That's why theoretically we study CLR. But normally, manually we don't design the parser, we use some kind of tool, say YACC, Y-A-C-C. So CLR, the concept, so constructing the CLR parser will help you to design LLR parser. That's why CLR parser is very important. Now, what is LLR parser? See, today we are going to see one grammar which we have already seen in previous lectures. We have designed the SLR parser for that grammar. So try to understand how many states are there in SLR parser, how many states are there in CLR parser, how many states are there in LLR parser. So you can summarize it in some page. So anyway, today we shall try to understand as CLR parser moves on some input string. Now this is only recap. I just want to say that LR1 item is nothing but it is a two component thing. It is a kind of two component thing. Two parts are there. So first part is called as a LR0 item and second part is called as a look ahead symbol. So there is a sample grammar is given, given sample is given. So normally it is represented in square brackets. So black line is there and red line is there. So first part is called as a core. Anyway, this was the example. So only three production rules are there. We have already designed this SLR parser. So I will just go through it and we shall understand how to compute the LR1 items, canonical set of LR1 items. Now, we already know the first and follow set, but here we have numbered the production rules. We have added something called as a new start symbol, that is S dash in the grammar. Now, this is called as a basis set. Please note this. This is very important. Your basis set, your computation of basis set should be important. So normally basis set starts with RHS, which has dot in the beginning. So S dash is giving you dot S, capital S. Capital S is a old start symbol in the grammar. This is a G dash grammar. And dollar, we know that it is a look ahead. Actually, look ahead is nothing but it is a look ahead means what? It is actually the content of first or follow set. Normally, follow set. So there is a look ahead symbol. And it is represented like this, in a brace bracket, in a square bracket, and that particular two components, LR0 atom and look ahead. So from this basis set, we compute the I0 atom, which is very important, because from I0, we generate I1, I2, I3, and so on, until we are not able to generate any more new sets. And what is this set? Set is nothing but it is representing some kind of some state in the DFA, LR1 DFA. So we have to take the closer of this basis set. Now, what is closure? So, rule is very simple. If you have dot in front of any capital letter that is non-terminal, just go to the refer to the original grammar and collect all the production rules. So, S dash is generating capital S, capital S is generating CC, and rule number one is generating 2 and 3. So we have to put all the production rules in the closure of this basis set. So while putting the items, so please, your note, you have to note this, that you have to compute, every time you have to compute the look ahead. Now, there is algorithm to compute the look ahead. I will be showing you in one slide how to compute the look ahead. Here again, you have to use the pattern matching like concept. You have to identify what is alpha, what is beta, and like that. And what is capital B. So this is a basic algorithm given. You just go through it later. It is given on page number 261. It is uploaded on the FTP site or Microsoft site, Office site. It is given. That full book is given to you for reference. So it contains three procedures. One is a set of items closure I. Then it calls go to IX, means set of items, go to IX. And there is the items in bracket G dash. So these are the three procedures which compose this complete algorithm for constructing LR1 item sets. So if you don't find it comfortable, don't worry about it. You just go through this slide. You take the snapshot of the site, take the screenshot. You can send a screenshot to me for my verification that you are receiving everything right. Nowadays, nobody is sending me screenshots. Anyway, see, friends, in red color, we have one sample LR1 atom. And here, there is a production rule where dot is somewhere. Now, here, dot is in front of capital B. See, this is an example. So, capital B is nothing but it is a non-terminal. So, in original grammar, B can have a large number of production rules. B may have maybe generating large number of production rules. So here in black color, B is generating something called as a gamma. B is generating gamma. So if you have some LR1 atom like this, then you have to add all the B production into the closure set. And you have to shift that dot one place ahead. You have to shift that dot one place ahead. See, in red color, B is in front of capital, dot is in front of capital B. So in your closure, dot will go one place ahead. But whatever you will add into the closure, those all production rules contain dot in front of each RHS of capital B. Means RHS of capital B non-terminal. So this is the rule. So please note this. Then, if you have something like this, you have to identify. See here, I am giving in a blue color, alpha, B, beta, and A. So small is representing any terminal. So it is an analogy. It is an analogy. So something can be empty or epsilon. So you have to add. See the last line, B giving you dot gamma, comma, B. Now what is this? Small b. So B is something combination of, first of combination of beta A. See, first is given in blue color. Beta A is given you in a red color. So what you have done? You have done concatenation. So beta can be empty, we don't know. Or A can be empty. A is a some terminal. So you have to compute first of beta A. That is a concatenation. Or a string beta A. So whatever first will be there, you will add like this. So you will add atom, LR1 atom into the closure of I. I is given in red color. So you will shift dot one place ahead, and then you will be adding some production roles in black color like this, whatever are there. And every production role will contain dot in the beginning, and comma B will be there. What is B? B will be something of first of that string. So this is the logic. So don't get panic. See this, it is very simple. It is simply a pattern matching mechanism, means a way of doing the things. So this is a interpretation of that algorithm, whatever we have seen in last slide. So let us go ahead. Now this is our I0. We know what is I, that is a basis set given in a blue color. Now what we have done, we have shifted. We should shift the dot in front of S to the end. Then we have to add all the production rules like this. We have to also compute the look ahead symbols like this. So this is sample. See, don't jump on any conclusion right now. So first is S is giving you dot capital CC comma dollar, and then remaining production rules are there represented in square brackets. So in this way we have some set containing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 LR1 atoms. Why LR1? Because it contains LR0 atom, comma, something look ahead. So this can be a sample LR1 atom. Now we can, there is one way to reduce representation. We can use slash to represent multiple LR1 components. So for example, here there is a brace bracket in blue color. See, RHS is same, but look ahead is different. CD is there. In the same way, there is a CD dot D is there, C dot D is there, but look ahead is small c and small d. So in such case, we can group them together. So we can represent them like this. So instead of showing all these six, we are representing in only 4 items. So what is happening here? C is giving you dot small c, capital C, comma, C. C is a look ahead, slash means OR. It is OR, slash is representing OR. That is a Boolean OR, either C or D, small d. So this is the way to write the LR1 component to reduce the representation. Otherwise, it will be your set. If you go for on real life example, your set will be very large. Even in one page, you will not be able to write it if you do not write in such a representation. Anyway, so this is the I0 atom. Now, just see what we have done here. Here just S dash arrow dot capital S and dollar is there. And this is your basis item. Now identify what is alpha. Alpha is epsilon. See the red color. In blue color box is there on the right hand side. There is a capital A arrow alpha dot capital beta B. Then beta is there, comma is there, small a is there. So you pattern match it. This box, this algorithm box with your basis set. So alpha is empty. Capital B is represented by S, capital S. Now beta is also empty, right? And A is representing dollar. Dollar is a actual look ahead. So naturally, first of beta A is a string. See, do not get confused here. Now beta is capital S. The S ka first kya hai? CD. See the follow first and follow table in a blue strip. So first of beta is CD. So it is written here like this. Dollar is at the end. So first, you know what is the logic of that, and that's why we have computed this. Anyway, let us go little ahead. So in this way, we have computed the I0 atom. I will come if someone has difficulty, he can ask me on my personal WhatsApp. Now, let us say that we have computed all the I0 atoms, I0 LR1 components. Now, how to compute the go-tos? See here, dot is in front of capital S, capital C is there, lowercase c is there, lowercase d is there. In this way, you can compute go-to. So go to I0 capital S, go to I0 capital C, go to I0 small c, go to I0 d, like this. So in this way, there are four transitions, right? So you can generate new states. You can give names like this if you are comfortable, if you know that. So, but later you have to take care that you should not repeat some state. For example, you might have computed I3 somewhere and you are giving it some name like I7. Aisa nahi hona chahiye. So anyway, so let us try to compute first go to I0S. Now, what is go to I0S means we are shifting dot one place ahead. So this is there. We are taking first go to I0S. So what will it contain? It will contain closure of S dash capital S and dot, and dollar will be there. Now see here, dot is at the end. So there is no need to add anything, because dot is already on the right hand side. So you can put this production rule as it is into the closure set, and you can name it like I1. I hope you got this. So in this way, we have computed first transition on I0. Now let us go for a second I0 capital C. Now see in black color, in red box, dot is in front of capital C. When you take go to, that dot will be shifted one place ahead, right? So dot will be in between two capital C's, and you have to keep look ahead as it is in first item, in closer item. So dollar will be as it is. Now you have to add other production rules by referring to the original set. Now see here in closer, first atom is as it is, second atom is from C, capital C. Now see dot is in front of capital C. Now you have to pattern match to the algorithm. Algorithm is given in a box, in bluish color box. Now alpha is represented by capital C. Capital B is represented by capital C. In this case, beta is empty, right? And terminal A is dollar. This is there. So without any extra thinking, you just do it mechanically. Now we have to compute first of beta A. So beta is empty and A is dollar, right? So first of beta A will be dollar, right? So you are adding all the production rules belonging to capital C from original set. So there are rule number 2 and 3 is there. You are adding as it is with dot in the beginning, and you are putting the look ahead symbol as per the algorithm. As per the algorithm, what is that? It is a first of beta A. So dollar, we have computed dollar. And that's why this set, we call it as I2, contains three production rules. In all three production rules, dollar is look ahead symbol like this. It is given. So we have computed second transition. So don't confuse, you have to go through the example again. You download the PPT and go through the example again for computing it. And if you want more confidence that how it is computed, you should write with pen and paper on your side. Without that, you will not understand anything. So anyway, this is second transition. Now let us say third transition. Now here, what is happening? Dot is in front of small c. If you take go to, dot will be shifted one place ahead. So what will happen? Dot will go after small c and it will be in front of capital C. And lookahead will be as it is in basis set of this particular closure. Now, as per rule, you have to add basis set into the closure set as it is. Now we know that dot is in front of capital C. That's why you have to refer the original grammar. You have to add rule number 2 and 3. They are red colored into your closure set. And you have to compute the new look aheads. Every time when you add some production rule, you have to compute new look aheads for that production rule. Now here again, you have to do the pattern matching mechanism. Here alpha, see, there is a black color. Here I have written there. Alpha is small c, capital B is capital C, beta is empty, and look ahead is C and T. That's why it is represented in brace bracket with comma. Okay. Now, beta is empty. So first stop that set CD will be as it is. First stop beta A will be as it is. So you have to attach those newly computed go tos with the help of function first stop beta A. So you got 3 production rules here. And all production rules containing C slash D as a look ahead. So I hope you got this. I hope you got this. So every time you have to refer the algorithm. So best way is that you should write in your copy somewhere. Now let us say third transition. So it is there. Now see, what you observe, dot is in front of small d. So if you take go to of that, dot will be shifted. Same logic is applicable to all whatever you are learning, SLR, CLR, LALR, same logic is used while computing go tos. So you are shifting dot, so dot will go at the end. Now see, dot is at the RHS, end of the RHS, right hand side of the production rule. So you cannot compute anything. That's why you are keeping that basis atom as it is into the closure set, and you are giving some name, say I4. So in here, in port transition, we have given name I4. So in this way, we have computed 4 sets. Actually, 5 sets are there. 0 is a initial set, and 1, 2, 3, 4 are 4 sets newly generated computed. Sets LR1 items. These are called as a canonical sets, collection of items. So in this way, 4 atoms are there. Now we have processed all the symbols in I0 set. Now you should try to process for go to transitions I1. But in I1, what is there? Dot is at the end. So there is no need to process. You cannot generate any transition from I1 set because dot is on the end of the RHS. I hope you are able to see the dots. Maybe people who are using mobile phones may not be able to understand what is the difference in comma and dot, but anyway, I suggest you download it and write it in a clear way. Without that, it may be a lot confusing. So anyway, from I1, you can't do anything. No transitions are possible, but you can consider I2, because in I2, dot is somewhere in between, in the beginning, like. So you can do some transitions here. You can compute some transitions here, like this. So that's why I've shaded I2 with a bluish box. So here, from I2, you can do transition on capital C, you can do transition on small c, you can do transition on small d. So now again, here, dollar is a current lookahead symbol. When you do the go-to, you have to compute new lookaheads as per the algorithm. So that is one extra step as compared to previous method, SLR method. So three transitions are possible, capital C, small c, and D, because only three production rules are there. So let us compute them. So you can give name if you are confident, like I5, I6, and I7. And sometimes it may happen that you may not be confident. So don't give directly some name like this. I have given names like I5, I6, and I7. You compute first set and then name it. Try to check whether it is already generated or not. If it is already generated, then don't generate new item name. You should use previous number. So let us compute first transition. Go to I2 capital C. So C is in front of, actually C is in between capital C's. So in go to, you have to shift dot at the end like this in black color. So this will be closer. So this will be basis atom of your closer. Now the dot is coming at the end. So you are not able to process anything because dot is at the end. So you keep basis atom into the closer set and just give name as I5. So in this way, first transition we have computed. Now second transition is there. Small c is there. Dot is in front of small c. If you compute go to, the dot will be shifted one place ahead. So it will be in front of capital C and it will be at the end of small c. And dollar will be look ahead in the original LR1 atom. Now you put this basis atom into closer set. Now dot is in front of capital C. Collect all the production rules like rule number 2 and 3 into closer set and compute beta A, first stop beta A. Now see, there is a production rule. So alpha is small c. This is a pattern matching with your algorithm. Capital B is a C. Beta is empty as per the pattern. And alpha, sorry, A is a terminal. Terminal look ahead is a dollar only. So first stop beta A. Beta is empty. So ultimately first stop beta A will be dollar. So you have to put this newly computed look aheads into closer set. Please note, your first basis atom hota hai, you have to keep look ahead as it is. Only you have to shift the dot one place ahead. But remaining atoms, whatever you are adding from the original grammar, you have to compute every time look ahead by using this algorithm. By computing first stop beta A. Beta, it can be some string. A can be some look ahead symbol, previous look ahead symbol. So here only three production rules are there as shown. Just name them I6. So in this way we have computed second transition on I2. Now Let us compute the third transition on small d. So see the arrow, bluish arrow. So what will be enclosure? Go to, you will be shifting dot at the end. So here it contains look at dollar and dot at the end of the production rule. So there is not possibility of generating any transitions, any additions. So you are keeping it as it is. So we have C giving you D, small d, and dot, comma, dollar. This is a LR1 component. So just call this as a IC1. So in this way, we have computed all three transitions on set I2 or state I2. So write them in boxes. I have written for simplicity, for getting the idea. In exam, you don't have to do like this. You have to refer the my PDFs, whatever I have circulated on the WhatsApp. You have to write in that fashion. Anyway, we have computed everything from I2 set. There is no more possibility, so we are switching to I3 state. It is again shaded into bluish box. Now here again, there are different positions. Dots are on different positions. But here in I3, you will find that lookaheads are C/D. Means two lookaheads are there everywhere. Slash means or. Now from I3, we can compute go to on capital C, small c, and small d. And just give name like I8, I3, and I4. So it is only for simplicity, because I know that what is happening. So I have given names in advance only for understanding. So let us compute the first transition for I3. Means it is a go to I3, comma, capital C, generating I set I8. So what will happen? The dot is in front of capital C. It was in between. Now in go to, it will go one place ahead. So dot will be at the end, and look ahead will be as it is in the basis set, in the original set. But dot is at the end, so we cannot do anything. So we are keeping same basis atom as it is into the closer set, and we are naming it as a I8. So first transition is over. Now let us compute the second transition, that is a go to of I3 small c. Now dot is in front of small c. If you compute closer go to, it will be shifted one place ahead like this. So dot will be in between small c and capital C. Look ahead will be as it is. You put this into the closer. Now dot is in front of capital C. You collect atoms from the original grammar, that is rule number 2 and 3, in a box given in on the left topmost corner, left top corner. Now we have to compute the new look aheads. So how they are computed? So write this in this fashion. So here alpha is a small c, beta capital B is a capital C, beta is empty, and look ahead terminal A is represented by C comma D. So first stop beta A. So beta A will be C comma D. So that's why we are putting newly computed look aheads in this way. So here from I3, we get same set. We are generating same set. So we are giving name I3. See, you can match it. So on go to on I3, on small c, you are getting I3 itself. Okay, so this is second transition. Now let us go ahead. So last transition, so rule is there, production rule is there, where dot is in front of small d. If you do go to of that, so you will be shift dot one place ahead. The dot will be at the end. You have to keep the look ahead as it is into the basis closer atom, basis atom. Now dot is at the end, so there is no need to compute anything more. So just name it as a I4. I4 is already computed. So on go to I3 small d, you are reaching into state number 4. It is already computed. So in this way, we have finished processing the I3 state. Now here, if you see I4 and I5, you will find that dots are already at the end. Dots are already reached at the end. So there is no need to compute transitions on these sets. Set number I4, set number I5. So let us switch to the sixth state, I6. So again, here look ahead is a dollar in all the production rules. So dot is in front of capital C, small c and small d. So there are three possibilities. So you can give the name I9, I6 and I7. So let us compute the first transition. Go to of I6 capital C. So dot will be moved one place ahead like this. You have to keep the original look ahead dollar as it is into the basis set. Now dot is at the end. So there is no need to compute. So you can collect this as I9. Okay. So first transition is over. Now see the second transition. Arrow is there. On small c, go to op I6 comma small c, giving you I6 itself. How? Just see, you are shifting dot one place ahead, that is a small c dot capital C comma dollar as it is. You are putting into the closer set. Now dot is in front of capital C, so you are collecting rule number 2 and 3 into the closer set. Now you want to compute the new look ahead. So here again do the pattern matching. So here alpha is small c, b is a capital B is a capital C, beta is empty. So first stop beta a will be dollar only. So this is the newly generated look ahead atom. So you are adding in remaining production rules at the end. So all these three production rules contains dollar as a look ahead in set number 6. So what is happening here? On transition on small c, if there is input small c, you are again going to the same state I6. So go to of I6 comma small c is equal to I6. So you are switching into same state. So this is how we have computed, finish all the transitions from set number I6 or I6 box, bridge box. Now see I7 and I8. So dot is already at the end. So there is no need to compute any transitions on this. So, and this is a I7 transition. So again, same thing is there. So you are generating I7. On transition small d. So in this way, we have generated 9 items. So actually 0 is there. 0 means 1 plus 1 to 3 4 up to 9 means total 10 states are there, 0 to 9. So we have this is called as a complete canonical set of LR1 atoms, complete set of canonical LR1 atoms, I0 to I9. Now we can construct the LR1 automata machine. You can call it as a DFA. And from that DFA, we can construct the parsing table. So friends, these are the go-tos. So these are the go-tos. So total 13 transitions are there. You can check, verify. From I0, there are 4 transitions. From I2, there are 3 transitions. From I3, there are 3 transitions. From I6, there are 3 transitions. In this way, total 13 transitions are there. So 13 transitions means there are 13 edges in a DFA. So 10 states are there, 0 to 9, and 13 edges are there. So in this way, you can tally your design. Now, what you have to do? You have to check which set contains dot at the end. See here, I1 is there, I4 is there, I5 is there, I7 is there, I8 is there, and I9 is there. Total 5 states are there where dot is and on the RHS, right hand side, end of the right hand side. So these states are representing something called as a reduce action. So what I have done, I have prepared one table. So first is there I1. So that is a initial state, start symbol is there. So it is accept state. Action is accept. But from I4 to I9, so typical rules are there. For example, rule number 3 is there. C is giving you D as per the grammar. S is giving you capital CC, rule number 1. Then C is giving you small c and capital C, rule number 2. So you have follow items are there. So LHS is there, RHS is there. That is the right hand side. So here, see, in a SLR parser, whatever you have done, we have mapped all the follow items into the parsing table. But in case of CLR, canonical LR table, we don't map all the follow items. We map follow items, but not all. What we do, we map only look ahead symbols. So look aheads are given in a separated comma in a square bracket. So C/D or something dollar. So these are the look aheads. So you have to map with them with reduce action. So for example, reduce by R3, reduce by R1, reduce by R2, like. So these are the rule numbers from original grammar. So friends, this is only for understanding. Here in CLR, what we are doing, we are not mapping all the follow items. We are mapping only look ahead symbols for mapping the reduce actions. Shift, you know, shift is plain, simple. So in this way, there is a DFA machine. So here, I don't know whether you are able to see this or not, but you download it and you can see, or you can go to the particular page and you will get the diagram in detail. You see the transitions. For example, I0 to I1 on input, capital S. So, or from I0 to I3 on input, small c. So in this way, total 10 states are there. Inputs are there. Capital letters are there, small letters are there. Small letter means terminals, capital letter means non-terminals. So the transition on capital letters are, you are mapping to go to. You are mapping to go to. And you are mapping small letters, terminals in the action part of your parsing table like this. See here, I0. State number I0 in table. This is the canonical CLR parsing table for given grammar. See here, you see the diagram I0 to I1 on input, yes. So that's why in go to part we have written 1. There is a transition from I0 to I2. So on capital letter C. So we have written here 2 in a go to part. Now you can see the state number 3 in a table. See, there is a 8 in column C. How? So in 3 state, you see that diagram enlarging, and on capital letter, you will get this transition, go to transition. So you have to map all the go-tos on capital letters, non-terminals. So there might be some columns, sales, blank. But in case of action part, if it is blank, you have to put dash there. You should not keep it blank. If you keep it blank, it means that you are missing something, you are not completed something. So it's the best way to put dash there in a cell. Now in blue color, S3 is there, S4 is there, S6 is there, S7 is there. So these are nothing but these are shift operations, next step. So if you see state number 0 and small c, so state number 0 and small c, you are switching into state number 3, S3. If it is D, you are switching into state number 4. If you are in a state 6, so on small c, you are reaching into same state, S6. But on D, you are reaching to 7 state, S7, like this. It is. So I have painted it in red, actually, but it should be in blue. But whatever red entries are there in action part, so that is a reduce action. So for example, state number 4. I don't know whether you are able to see state number 4 or not, but what you are doing here in reduce action, you are mapping only the leucoid symbol. So there is some table given on the side. So state number 4, see the I4 in blue. So C and D is there and reduces R3. So you are writing R3 into C and D column. In same way, you are writing R1 in dollar column in state number 5, I5. So dollar is there. So in this way, you have to understand it carefully. For example, state 9 is there. You are mapping R2 there in dollar column, action area, action part. So you have to understand this. So now, friends, time is over, but I will just go through quickly. I will take only 1 minute, don't worry. Aaj kya attendance kam hai kya bhai? Anyway. So this is the LR1 automata. This is a CLR parsing table. Now this is the idea. So we want to parse the CDD. This is the input token string of tokens. 3 characters are there. Dollar is a limiter, is a centennial. So this is your input buffer. Your pointer will be moving from one cell ahead. You will be referring the parsing table as per the top of the entry or in the stack. You will be referring the action part or in go to part, and you will be processing the string. So let us say CDD input buffer, you are pointing, C is pointed by the buffer pointer. 0 is the initial state, current state, initial state. So 0C you refer. So there is a S3 shift action is there. So your next state will be 3. So in a step number 2, so what you have done, you have shifted C into the stack. And you have shifted 3 on the top of the stack. So 0, C and 3, these are the contents of the stack. So 3 is on the top of the stack. Now the buffer is pointing to D only, because C is moved, small c is moved into the stack, shifted into the stack. Now 3D, so if you refer the parsing table, 3D, there is action, shift action, that is S4. So next state will be 4. So you will shift into, means you will push D into the stack. So like this. So it will take 8 steps to compute and accept the given string CDD dollar. And these are the actions, maybe reduce action or shift action. So I suggest you, friends, to practice it on your home. At home, you write it in your copy. Then you can learn a lot of many things which you may have missed through lectures. So I am sorry, I am taking too much time, but Thank you for listening me carefully without anyway, if you face any difficulty, please ask me, do not hesitate, but send information or question you on my personal WhatsApp. So friends, I am going to close this. Thank you for listening me patiently. Thank you very much.